Ayanna was a sick baby when she was young with bronchitis, had some constant chest infections, and then I had asked for some more tests to be done because I, as a parent, I knew something was wrong. She had some procedures done and yeah, we found out that she had bronchiectasis. Ayanna travels every 3 months from the Kimberleys down to Perth and has ongoing admissions 2 to 3 weeks at a time. Sorry.
13% of children in a community has a condition that's going under-recognised, undetected, undertreated, and it could harm these children. In preschool children going to daycare, at any given time, half of them will have a wet cough. And I think that's part of the reason why chronic wet cough goes undetected, because people see a child with a wet cough and they think that's okay. I've been doing clinics up in the Kimberley and Pilbara with a team, and we realised that we see too many Aboriginal children with bronchiectasis. And we also realised that many of them have chronic wet cough and a condition called protracted bacterial bronchitis that then develops to bronchiectasis. So if a wet cough is there and it doesn't go away, there's a very high chance that that child has protracted bacterial bronchitis. And what that is a low-grade infection on the inside of the airways. And if you leave it, it eats away at the inside of the lungs.
Until Kayana was diagnosed, I didn't know much about it. Having that awareness around from Dr. Andre, I just felt it was good to know the condition Kayana had and what the long-term effects could be.
Until now, the best estimates we had for bronchiectasis numbers to be about 1 in 65 to 68 children. What we've done is gone out to communities. We recruited almost all the children under the age of 7, and we found accurately that 13% of these children had chronic wet cough and 10% had protracted bacterial bronchitis. When they went to clinic and got the right treatment, they got better. And some of them had been coughing for almost a year.
It is a common problem up in the Kimberleys. A lot of parents aren't aware of the condition. Going through it with Kayana, I used to, you know, let a lot of parents know about it. They've had the wet cough for a certain amount of time. Best thing to do is get them checked, because it could cause further problems down the track.
We hope to develop a strategy for a national health information campaign, and we hope that it's two-pronged. One prong is to work with you know, to raise awareness with families and to motivate them to go to doctors, and the other one is to actually then follow how that information spread and then target health information and training for health practitioners and doctors in those areas, so that when the parents seek help, they can get the help.